let's take a look at the Bernoulli distribution, another important discrete probability distribution. Here's an example. Suppose we toss a fair coin once. What is the distribution of the number of heads in that single toss? Well, it's going to have a Bernoulli distribution. Suppose we have a single trial, where each trial can result in one of two possible mutually exclusive outcomes, and we're going to label those two outcomes success and failure. The probability of success on that trial is going to be represented by little p, and the probability of failure must be 1 minus p. We're going to let the random variable x equal 1 if a success occurs, and 0 if a failure occurs. And if these conditions hold, then x has what we call the Bernoulli distribution, where the probability the random variable x takes on the value little x is equal to p to the x, 1 minus p to the 1 minus x. And we sometimes write this as just little p of x. You might see it written that way sometimes. Now, what we should do is say what values x can take on. And so we write here for little x being equal to 0 or 1. And so all of this we refer to sometimes as the probability mass function of the Bernoulli distribution. And if we were to write this out for the individual values, we'd see that the probability the random variable x takes on the value 1 is equal to p to the 1, 1 minus p, to the 1 minus 1, which is just equal to p. And the probability that the random variable x takes on the value 0 is equal to p to the 0, 1 minus p, to the 1 minus 0, which is just 1 minus p. The probability of success and the probability of failure that we talked about previously. So what we have up here is just a way of writing that in one line. Now it can be shown without too much difficulty that the mean of a Bernoulli random variable is equal to p, and the variance of a Bernoulli random variable is equal to p times 1 minus p. Approximately 1 in 200 American adults are lawyers. Suppose we randomly sample one American adult. We might ask ourselves, what is the distribution of the number of lawyers? Well, we've got a single trial. Each person is a lawyer or they are not. And the conditions of the Bernoulli distribution here are satisfied. So the number of lawyers is going to have a Bernoulli distribution with parameter p. And p is going to be simply the probability that any one individual person is a lawyer, which is about 1 in 200. And if we let the random variable x represent the number of lawyers in our sample of size 1, then the probability that the random variable x takes on the value little x is going to be equal to p to the x, which is 1 over 200 to the x, times 1 minus p, which is 1 minus 1 over 200, to the 1 minus x. And this is for x equaling 0 or 1, because we're either going to get one lawyer or none. And if we substituted these values in here, we'd see that the probability that we do get one lawyer is going to be equal to 1 over 200, and the probability that we don't get a lawyer, or get zero lawyers, is going to simply be 199 over 200. Now you might be wondering, what is the point of all of this? We had that approximately 1 in 200 American adults are lawyers, so it's certainly not rocket science to say the probability that we get one lawyer is 1 in 200. But saying that something has a Bernoulli distribution is a nice, concise description of the situation at hand. Some other common discrete probability distributions are built on the assumption of independent Bernoulli trials. For example, here we have the binomial distribution, the geometric distribution, and the negative binomial distribution. The binomial distribution is the distribution of the number of successes in n independent Bernoulli trials. The geometric distribution is the distribution of the number of trials to get the first success in independent Bernoulli trials. And the negative binomial distribution is the distribution of the number of trials to get the rth success in independent Bernoulli trials. And so we have a number of these other distributions that are built on this assumption of independent Bernoulli trials. And we'll talk about some of those distributions a little bit later on.